Some years ago, we started working on our multilingual online dictionary Porlex. This initial work made us realize that there were, at the time, not many online resources that explain valency patterns in nouns. Today, we advanced the results of our first prototypes for semi-automatic generation of mono-argumental and bi-argumental valency patterns with a focus on the nominal phrase. The aim of the study is to present the tool Combinatoria, a new prototype for automatic generation of bi-argumental valency patterns for the nominal phrase in Spanish, German, and French, as well as the current developments of our simulators. Combinatoria is not a standalone product. We introduce here a set of prototypes developed as exploratory tools to establish our methodological approach. The prototypes show a new concept of electronic multilingual dictionary, in this case, automatic and more interactive valency dictionaries. In the next slide, we will focus therefore on the features of the language generators. All simulators provide information about the noun valency and are based on a combined methodological approach. On the one hand, they combine different linguistic theories, such as valency grammar, prototype theory, and so on. On the other hand, they implement NLP techniques, GORTNET and GORTNET-like lexical databases, and also other human-made multilingual resources for automatically generating lexicographic content. Combinatoria is closely related to the mono-argumental simulator Shera, whose data are used as the basis for the bi-argumental combinatoria. It is also related to the mono-argumental simulator Shera that provides examples in Galician and Portuguese, and to Combi Context, our generator capable of working with both phrasal and verbal paradigms. All simulators are independent lexicographic tools for humans, also integrable into other types of resource and may even export it as computational lexicons. As mentioned before, the tools provide information on the active and passive noun valency. For this purpose, each valency slot is described based on the syntactic semantic interface of the noun and their combinatory rules. As the starting point for verifying the feasibility of the methodological proposal and ultimately the prototypes themselves, 20 nouns in Spanish, German, and French have been selected as representatives of different cognitive scenes or semantic fields, as shown in this table. This slide summarizes the general features of the designed generators. Regarding features as the language involved, the valency patterns, the data access, and so on. In the following slide, we would mention the linguistic description levels and some key concepts. All four simulators are based on the same linguistic levels. The one difference concerns the last generator currently in progress because it focuses on passive noun valency, that is the phrasal and sentence context of the nominal phrase. The table on the right shows a concrete example of these levels with some quantitative information for the German noun, Diskussion. In our approach, lexical unit and lexical package are also key concepts, not only from a linguistic point of view, but also from a programming perspective. For our prototypes, we have to establish a paradigm of lexical units or classe d'objet, since the properties of the nominal predicate condition the paradigm of lexical candidates that fit into a valency slot. For this task, we resort to GORTNET. Therefore, it's necessary to get and prototype a list of adequate lexical candidates and to encode their combinatory rules and restrictions. On the other side, a lexical package consists of a set of related lexical units that, although not interchangeable, have a similar paradigmatic relationship and includes a list of forms together with a unique ID and ontological information. In order to make the procedures more automatic, we developed the tool TraduWord, an open source based translator.
As the research progressed, the workflow and goals of the project also evolved. This led to the implementation of new resources and methodologies. These novelties were mainly new internal or external tools that helped with the automation of tasks, or sometimes they were also new tasks assigned to humans. A combination of internal and external tools, therefore, is used in our platform, mainly to perform morphosyntactic and semantic analysis, expansion and translation of lexical data, preparing the data to feed the generator, and development of the generators themselves. These tasks were often involved with some kind of human interaction. Researchers were mainly responsible for the formulation of the initial queries used in the corpora, analyzing and collecting data sets, and debugging any of the automatic procedures developed. Continuing with these tasks already mentioned in the previous slide, when we talk about morphosyntactic and semantic analysis, we refer to the process of obtaining argument patterns. In order to achieve this, first, Sketch Engine and Porlex are used as the main source of data, which are then queried to extract morphosyntactic patterns. This data is manually annotated using valency dictionaries as a reference and with our own ontology as a frame in the background of reference. In order to collect relevant lexical units, we decided to take advantage of the multilingual scene sets of WordNet through our own tool Lemmatiza. The input of Lemmatiza is a list of concordances extracted from Sketch Engine, and the output is a list of potential lexical candidates that will get filtered by applying the researcher's desired lexical selection on our second tool, Combina. The results of Combina are a collection of lemmas that fit the criteria and will be inflected and packaged before being sent to the generator. Finally, we have also developed TraduWord that is a automatic translator that allows us to repurpose the lexical packages by automatically translating them into a new target language. The list of items provided by Combina needs to be inflected before being understood by the generator. For this purpose, we've built Flexiona, a multilingual inflector based on Freelang. Before uploading the results to the server, they must be validated by humans. Further corrections that were not detected during automatic inflection or human validation are also possible with internal tools. Also, already uploaded packages may be repurposed. This means that the paradigmatic information linked to the existing package may be added to new ones. This workflow described here has produced, on average, 152 structures for each of the nouns selected, over 32,000 distinct lemmas, and over 3,000 distinct argument patterns. We will see now briefly how to use the tool Combinatoria. The user must choose one of the languages, and one of the possible nouns will be also selected. Then the user will be led to a screen where a list of all possible ontological semantic arguments are displayed. Upon selecting the first argument, a table with examples and possible combinations will appear. Using the second filter will limit the possible phrases that can be combined to those that include the first and second arguments selected. Upon clicking on the examples, a list of phrases will appear below. We can see here the process. We have selected the first and second argument. There is only one structure in this case that fits the criteria. And upon clicking on it, the examples will be generated in such a manner. The output may also be downloaded. The user can choose either a JSON export or CSV format. Currently, we are working on combi context. We have already mentioned it briefly. It's a sentence generator, and it's an expansion of the combinatorial tool. In order to achieve this, we have to parse open source corpora. Mainly, we're working with Wikipedia and extract relevant verbs for each noun with our own parser. We believe that what we have developed so far can be used as a tool for language learners, especially for beginners and intermediate students that struggle to grasp the valency rules of the new language. We also believe that this resource is also of great value for lexicography. The resources may work as a standalone product for lexicographers, but they may also be integrated into other lexicographic work as a support tool, or some of the tools developed along the way during this project may be implemented to streamline the workflow of other syntactic semantic projects. To conclude, we believe that tools that describe the combinatory potential of a noun are a valuable resource for language learners. And with this as our starting point, we have presented a validated methodological approach that describes the valency of a noun that was integrated into the resources via an ontology-based interface. Finally, the scope of the tool is still too narrow. The number of study units needs to be larger for the finalized product to be relevant. Feedback from our first workshop with this tool as the protagonist implies that further research needs to be carried out to improve the user's experience. This is all from us. Thank you very much.